Change is afoot in the Arctic Circle, which is an imaginary line encircling Earth at 60 degrees 30 minutes north of the equator. Greenland, for instance, is losing its ice at unprecedented rates. What does this mean for the rest of the world? The answer, according to some experts, is that no one is immune to Arctic warming. About 8,000 years ago, the Earth exited its last ice age. During this period, ice sheets covered large portions of the world. Ice sheets form when snow that accumulates in the winter melts incompletely in the summer. When layers of snow gather for thousands of years, they form large masses of ice called ice sheets. Now, only two ice sheets, Greenland in the North Pole and Antarctica in the South, exist. In our previous episode, we looked at why the Arctic is warming up about three times faster than the rest of the world. Click on the top right corner to watch it. In this episode, we'll go on a short virtual hike across Greenland, exploring how climate change is making the region unstable. Greenland is an island nestling between the Arctic and the Atlantic Ocean. This is Greenland's size with respect to India. The island is home to polar bears, humpback whales, musk oxen, walruses, and reindeer. Over 56,000 people live in the region. About 80% of the landmass is ice sheet. It is about 2,400 kilometers long and 1,100 kilometers wide. The ice sheet plays a vital role in regulating the planet's temperature, sea levels, currents, and storm patterns. Greenland's ice holds 8% of fresh water on the planet. Greenland is changing. Typically, Greenland's ice melts in the summers, but it makes up for the lost ice in the winters. But rising temperatures are accelerating the melting, thereby causing a loss in ice mass. During warm summers, the ice witnesses more melt days. Ice sheet melting went up by 30% from 1979 to 2006. There are other culprits too. Dust and pollutants from far-flung areas land on the ice sheet, causing them to darken. Consequently, the darkened ice absorbs more sunlight, driving further melting. Add snow algae to the mix, we see faster melting. These organisms produce pigments that absorb more sunlight. On the surface of the ice sheets, ice melts to form meltwater runoff. These runoffs can drain into ponds or lakes. The lakes, scientists believe, escape into holes appearing on the ice. Scientists call these holes moulins. Through these moulins, the meltwater enters the interior of the ice sheet, reaching all the way to the bed. It then could be making its way to the glaciers lining the coast. Glacier is a large mass of ice that flows over land. The meltwater is less dense than salt water, and so it rises up as plumes. Further, warm Arctic waters accelerate melting of glaciers. The meltwater brings the warm and salty waters into close contact with the base of the glacier, thereby melting it from the bottom up, according to NASA. Eventually, a piece of the glacier breaks off to form icebergs. Greenland's teeming wildlife is under pressure to adapt to this changing environment. For instance, warming temperature and ice loss is likely to reduce the polar bear population in the region by up to 30% in the next few decades. What does Greenland's ice loss mean for the rest of the world? Greenland lost an average of 200 gigatons of ice per year between 2003 and 2019. This, along with Antarctica's average ice sheet loss, caused sea levels to rise by 14 millimeters over those 16 years. Sea level rise could cause coastal flooding, it could contaminate agricultural soil with salt, and cause cyclones to become more intense. If Greenland's ice sheet were to melt entirely, global sea levels could rise by 17 to 23 feet in a millennium. We will talk more about the Arctic in the next couple of episodes. Do stick around. Please also don't forget to provide us with your valuable feedback.